Welcome to church!
Top of the morning to you on this St. Patrick's Day, everybody. We're so glad you could join us. We are ready to enter into the presence of God. I'm Cameron Fontana.
And I'm Elisa Henry, and I don't have the accent.
I think
next
you could try
year.
It, Elisa. We could have the accent. People watching from Ireland going, oh, no, not now, Cameron.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. We are so, so blessed to say it is Sunday.
Yes.
Happy Sunday to all of you joining us this morning.
And again, if you're watching online, the greatest way you can connect with us and evangelize to your world is by clicking that share button and also letting us know what you're believing God to do and where you're watching from.
Yeah, we got people already chiming in, ready for service this morning. Good morning to Alicia. Good morning to Samuel. He's in Kenya.
Watching from Kenya.
Love
That's
that.
Incredible. Lisa's watching from Hawaii. Dr. Richard Valentine is also watching from here in Columbus as well. And listen, if you're in the Columbus area, mm-hmm. we have a very big event that's happening in less than 1 week next Saturday.
Yes, the Bunny Breakfast.
Oh,
and it
bunny.
Is free for our community. We are so excited. It's for everyone in the family, whether you have little kids, big kids, or you're a kid at heart, you are welcome to join us at the Bunny Breakfast on Saturday at 10 a.m.
And it's so easy to invite people. Everyone knows what a bunny breakfast is going to mm-hmm. be. They're going to be delicious food.
Yes.
There's going to be activities for the kids. So tell everyone you know it's absolutely free.
Free.
To register and find out more information, go to whc.life.
And we have what I believe to be the greatest week in our Christian
oh, yes.
lives coming up. Holy Week, we have Easter coming, celebrating the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. There's so many things happening here at the Harv. This is a place to yeah. be for Easter week.
And there's no weekend like Easter weekend mm-hmm. at World Harvest Church. So Friday night, Good Friday, Holy Communion, want to bring the whole family out. The kids are doing a walk through the Bible, a journey with Jesus.
Yes.
And then Easter Sunday morning, we got a big day planned.
Yes, we have Shayna Wilson-Williams whoop, whoop. Joining Harvest Music Live for worship. We also have an enormous food distribution. We're talking 40,000 pounds of food
wow.
that we are giving away to the community, making it so easy for us to bless people. And we have great ways for you to invite people as well.
Right, and great ways for you to volunteer. So if mm-hmm. you want to find out more information, WHC.life to help with our outreaches, spread the word,
yes.
spread the Bible, and also tell people about Easter. And we're going to talk about it again later in service.
We
it's
will.
That big. That's
we will.
Why.
And if you aren't able to join us, you know, through outreach in person, there's still ways that you can share online what we're doing here at the Harv, because maybe there's somebody that's following you that can make it. So make sure that you're sharing everything that's happening here, and maybe you can give someone the opportunity to join us in person.
You don't have to lick stamps anymore and send
no.
someone a letter. You can just click a button on your phone.
Yes.
Well, we're going to get out of the way. Mm-hmm. We're going to enter into some praise and worship. So there's only one more thing to say.
Service will begin in 90 seconds.
Well,
good morning, World Harvest Church!
How many people are excited to be in the house of God today? I'm telling you, when the weather's above 50 degrees, Elisa, we get really happy here in
yes.
Ohio.
Blessing, the sunshine is shining on me.
Well, we're getting ready for a lot of blessing this morning. We want to welcome everyone watching online, also at our Elkhart, Indiana campus. Thank you for joining us. We have a big service plan for you all.
Yes.
Yeah.
And so right now, we are going to set the atmosphere, get ready
yes.
for this service. And I'm going to say a quick prayer. Heavenly Father, we come to you right now. Lord, we just thank you for this day. We thank you for the opportunity to come together. Lord, your word says where two or three are gathered in your name, there you are in the midst of them. We know, Lord, that there are a lot of people carrying a lot of things this morning, but your word says to cast our cares on you, for you care for us. And we just thank you, Lord, that right now we lay those burdens at your feet and we lift our hands to you, God, and we say that you alone, Lord, are worthy. We give you all the praise, all the glory, all the honor. In Jesus' name, amen. Please welcome Harvest Music Live.
Come on, let's bless him together. This song is a declaration of our faith. We got some believers in the room. Come on, I hear you. F-Heart, let's go. Instagram, YouTube, WHC.live. We're going to declare the goodness of God together and our faith in his word. Here we go.
I believe there is one salvation, one doorway that leads to life, one redemption, one confession. I believe in the name of Jesus Christ.
We believe, amen. Come on.
I believe in the crucifixion. By his blood I have been set free. I believe in the resurrection. Hallelujah, his life is destined to be.
That's good news right there. Come on, here's our praise.
All praise to God the Father. All praise to Christ the Son. All praise to the Holy Spirit. Our God has overcome. The King who was and is and evermore will be. Yep. In Jesus' mighty name.
I believe in the hope of heaven.
I believe in the hope of heaven. He's preparing a place for me, far beyond what hearts imagine, ears have heard, or eyes have seen. I believe that a day is coming. He's returning to claim his bride. Light the altar, keep it burning. See the Lamb who rose up.
Amen. Come on, redeem.
No one ever be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. How could I ever walk away from the one who saved my life?
You gotta say.
All praise to God the Father. All praise to Christ the Son.
Sounds good, church.
All praise to the Holy Spirit. Our God has overcome. Uh-huh. The King who was and is
forever. He will be.
Yes. Jesus' mighty name, I believe.
One more time. Say.
All praise to God the Father, and all praise to Christ the Son, all praise to
He's a God of his word. He's never failed us and he never will. Lord, we thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your goodness. God, we thank you for your goodness. All right, hands up all across the room if you're able this morning as we worship our King together. Come on, El Carton, lift him high. Oh, we love you, Lord. You are holy, none like you. Set apart, different from the rest. Sing this with us, here we go.
Thousand generations calling down in worship to sing the song of ages to the land.
Yep.
And all who've gone before us and all who will believe will sing the song of ages to the land.
Come on, say.
Your name is the highest.
Yeah, God. Hallelujah. Stands above them all.
All thrones and dominions, all powers and positions, your name stands above them all.
Here we go.
And the angels cry.
Lift it up.
Holy, all creation cry.
We say, walk in freedom. Come on, redeem.
If
you bear that precious name, then sing it out.
Yeah.
it up, church. Lift it up. Your name is the highest. Your name is the greatest. Your name stands above them all thrones and dominions, all powers and positions. Your name stands above them all. You know, my heart goes out this morning. Keep it up, man. To people online and our Elkhart campus and right here in this room, and maybe you've got a diagnosis that the doctor has given you, or you've got a situation in your life and you need to be reminded that His name is higher. His name is greater. I know it might seem great and it might be great, but you got to be reminded this Sunday morning, His name is higher, His name is greater, His name is tested, His name is proven, His name is faithful. His name will work for you this morning. As we lift up that name today, be encouraged, beloved. I feel hope rising. I feel expectation increasing this Sunday morning. Yeah, stands above them all. Your name is the highest.
Worthy is the name. Amen. The name above every name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Worthy, worthy. God, you are so worthy. Jesus, you are so worthy. Worthy is your name. Worthy above everything. Above everything, anything we've been dealing with this week, Lord, your name is that name above every name. If we can name it, your name is above that. We can name that thing, that sickness, that disease, that situation. If you can name it, his name is above that name, worthy to his name. Amen.
Pastor, amen. I don't mean to take a moment, but the presence of God is here. And I just felt God speak to me over something that's been going on the past few weeks. Nothing bad, but my daughter rides in the car with me every time I pick her up from school. And you guys can keep that song going because there's an anointing on that, Pastor Chris. But my daughter would go in, and in the car, she'd say, Dad, can you play Holy? The song we played second. And most of the time, I'm like, yes, I can. But sometimes, if it's not, I say, Chanel, I'll do it in a couple moments. And then she'll ask again, Dad, can you play Holy? Can you play Holy? And then she starts singing it in the back seat, the same way I've heard Alexander and Lisa's son sing and so many of our kids sing. And it just brought to mind that our children will prophesy. And not until this morning, I know we're ready in the resurrection season, but Miss Ashton said in our dream team this morning that we're getting ready to enter Holy Week, the most important week of the entire year. And there's such an anointing on that for us to seek a holy fire, to have a holy people, because we serve a holy God. What Miss Ashton said earlier. And I've never done this, but can we just take a moment to worship under that word, to call him holy, because he is. He's been so good to us. And like Pastor Chris said, if there's been a diagnosis or something in your life that's tried to keep you down, it can be hard. I've been there. It can be hard to still proclaim him holy, that he's above the diagnosis. He's above the negativity. He's above what the news says. He's above what your kids might be going through. He's above what your parents might be going through. So if we could just take a moment to really dive in and understand the meaning of that word, because we call him holy. Yes, Jesus. And I'm sorry to take a moment, but he is holy, God. We thank you for this church. We thank you for our family members that are saved, our family members that are not saved, to give us the fire, God, to give us the spirit of motivation to invite people this resurrection season, that things we thought that were dead are going to be brought back to life. And things that we thought were dead are going to be brought back to life once and for all. We thank you, God. We call you holy, holy, holy.
And the angel cried, holy, 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 holy.
Tabernacle Church. Lift it up. My God.
People sing. We say, oh.
Let the redeemed cry, holy. Let the born again cry, holy. Let the fire baptized cry, holy. Let the healed cry, holy. Let the joyful cry, holy. Let the victorious ones cry, holy. Though you are weak, we declare we are strong in Jesus. Holy, 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 holy.
Who may ascend the hill of the Lord? Who may stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who has not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor sworn deceitfully, he will receive the blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is Jacob, the generation of those who seek him and who seek your face. Lift up your heads, O you gates, and be lifted up, you everlasting doors, that the King of Glory may come in. Who is this King of Glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, be ye lifted up, you everlasting doors, that the King of Glory may enter. Who is this King of Glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle, the Lord who takes away the sin of the world, the Lord who washes us white as snow, the Lord whose blood redeemed us and saved us and delivered us, the Lord who rids us of the noisome pestilence, the Lord who heals us, the Lord who saves our family members, the Lord who calls forth a generation of those that will diligently seek him, the Lord strong and mighty, mighty in battle, Jehovah Izu's Hagaboth, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Eli, Jehovah Adon Cal Harris, Jehovah Nisi, my banner and my righteousness. Whom shall I fear? For the Lord is with me. I'm just quoting the Bible to you today. I can feel that so many of us are in a season where we feel weary in well-doing. We're doing our 40-day fasting guide. We're in our Crown Him King devotional. We're in the Word. We're reciting our scripture of the decade, Psalm 81:10. We're coming to church faithfully. We're worshiping in our car. We're trying to raise our kids upright. But it just seems like you're pushing a rope uphill, and you can never get to the other side of the battle that you're facing. But can I tell you today that all you have to do is lift up your head and look toward the hills from whence cometh your help. Many are they increased that trouble you, and many are they that rise against you. But when you look to the hill from whence cometh your help, you can't help but be stirred up in your most holy faith. And that's what faith is. It's simply trusting God to be who he is. Trusting God to do what he does. And what he does is give us victory. Our victory is assured. This word says so. And this word is truth. And it is life. It doesn't matter what the facts say, what your circumstance says, what the diagnosis says, what people on the internet say, because you have a hold of absolute truth. And our pastor teaches us that when you do, you let nothing and no one turn your plow. You let nothing and no one distract you. And just like Mary with her alabaster box, when you feel like you've given him all you can, you just give him your best worship. Because
because when he went to that cross, he tore that veil and gave us free access into his presence, where there is fullness of joy. Fullness of joy. At his right hand are mercies forevermore. And you can access that today here in this room, watching online. You can access it in your child's bedroom. You can access it in your closet at home. You can access it in the bathroom at work. You have free access to his presence, and therefore you have free access to anything and everything that you could ever want or need. All you have to do is just keep worshiping. Keep calling him holy. Keep calling him righteous. Keep calling him sovereign. Keep calling him worthy. He is worthy of it all. He's worthy of all of your praise, all of your adoration, all of your dedication, all of your worship. I'm putting you on the spot, Pastor Chris, but I just hear worthy is your name. Jesus,
worthy
you deserve
is
the praise.
Your name, Jesus, you deserve the praise. Come on. And worthy is your name. And worthy is your name, Jesus. Jesus, you deserve. And you deserve. Come on.
There's no God like Jehovah.
What?
There's no God like Jehovah.
Hey, hey, hey.
Lord. Somebody shout unto God like you believe it.
Yeah. Woo. Hallelujah.
I thought Pastor Chris was going to have us sing. I said, I don't know if I'm anointed for that yet. Oh, amen. Thank you so much, World of Harvest Church. You may be seated.
Amen.
How thankful are you, everyone watching online, for a church that just follows the Spirit of God? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, things are moving. Things are getting ready to resurrect because Easter is just around the corner. We're going to talk about that in a little bit, but first we got some things to tell you about.
Well, I'm Alisa Henry, yes. Longtime member here at World Harvest Church, graduate of Harvest Preparatory School and Valor Christian College.
Yes, and I'm Cameron. I serve with Harvest Music Live. Woo! And if this is your first time joining us, we want to welcome you.
Welcome.
They're going, wow, they do a lot here. This is who we are.
That's who we are. That's right. We want to connect with you. There's a connect card in the seat pocket in front of you. All you have to do is fill that out, give it to a Dream Team member, or you can put it in the container when offering comes by later on in the service.
And in addition to that, you can see one of our amazing Dream Team members on your way out in any of the foyers. They can bless you. They can give you more information, answer any questions. And we also want to hook you up with a free gift from our pastor and his family. So don't leave without your free gift.
That's right. And Easter, as we said, is right around the corner. How many of you are looking forward to Good Friday?
Yes!
That is one of my personally favorite services during Easter weekend. The way we do Good Friday here is like nowhere else. Be sure that you are here. It's Holy Communion service, a time for us to be able to set the atmosphere and just really set our lives aside and be in the place of God. Make sure that you are here. If you're able, be here for Good Friday, 7 p.m. We're gonna have communion, and we're also gonna have, for the kids, Journey Through the Bible.
Yes.
Miss Katie, our children's director, does an amazing job. She sets up that entire Hall of Faith area. I mean, the things that the kids are learning is mind-blowing. They are learning about the Bible, learning about the things of God, and they're doing that in Kid Harvest, so you don't want to miss Good Friday service, 7 p.m. Be here in the building.
And they get to see the tomb that is empty. Woo! On Easter Sunday morning. And we're very excited. There's no weekend like Easter weekend here at World Harvest Church. We're going to have an amazing word, amazing worship with special guests. Miss Shayna Wilson Williams is going to come back with us. And then our kids are going to go through the great Eggscape. Somebody say Eggscape!
Eggscape!
They're going to have giveaways. They're going to have all sorts of puzzles and games and an amazing time for the kids. There's going to be an outdoor egg hunt. It is back! So listen, you don't have to do the egg hunt at your house. You can do it here. We have tons of eggs. So you can even search for the eggs too. That's okay. We have enough for everybody. That's 10 a.m. Easter Sunday morning.
And for the community, we have a drive-through grocery distribution.
Yes.
We're talking 40,000 pounds of food.
Wow.
That we are giving away to everyone in this place as well as the community. It's a drive-up situation. You get to be blessed on Easter Sunday. So be sure to invite people. And Cameron's gonna tell us how to do that.
Yeah, it's one thing to be able to say, hey, we're giving away 40,000 pounds of food. Check. Hey, there's giveaways for your kids in an outdoor egg hunt. Check. But we're making it so simple. This week, we're incorporating jelly beans.
Jelly bean carrots. Look,
jelly bean carrots. How many people love jelly beans?
Woo!
Most
Our
of the people.
Our pastor says they're really good, so they're really good.
And they look cool, too. So we have these in the foyers after service. That way, you can hand them out. Listen, these are the same things as the It's On Us cards. If you go through the drive-thru, bless someone with their coffee, leave the carrot. Yes. At your work, throw it on someone's desk without telling them, and they'll be like, what's this? So many different ways to use this.
Absolutely. And then next Sunday, everyone say next Sunday.
Next Sunday.
The great thing about the Harvest is it's very come as you are. I'm like kind of dressed up this morning. Camera's kind
of
casual.
Wait. Alisa just said I'm kind of dressed up. Can we give a round of applause that she looks amazing today?
I'm just saying that it's next Sunday is casual Sunday, so everybody come casual because it's also serve day. So we're gonna have an amazing service, but then after service, lunch will be provided for everyone, and then we're going to get this place ready for Easter. And it gives you all a great opportunity to serve, and we're making it easy by making it on Sunday. In years past, it's been Saturday, but now you're already coming to church on Sunday. Plan to stay and hang out with us and get this place ready for Easter Sunday and all of the guests that are coming on Sunday.
And we also want to give you opportunities to outreach, to invite people to the church. So this Saturday and next Saturday at 9:45, I believe, starting up, you can meet right here at World Harvest Church. If you're not part of the Bunny Breakfast and you just want to go and hand flyers out, bless the community, this Saturday, next Saturday, we can do just that. Because we want to give you the opportunity to get out in our neighborhoods.
And there's been some amazing outreaches already.
Yes.
We are so thankful for everyone who showed up. Miss Ashton went through it in our dream team meeting. We are so thankful for everyone who's been showing up for outreaches. And there's still plenty of time for you to participate this Saturday and next Saturday. And this Saturday, we have the Bunny Breakfast.
Bunny Breakfast!
I'm super excited. We're bringing that back. It's free to the community. Camera's going to hop around like that the entire breakfast. But we're going to show you a video. Please turn your attention to the screens.
What's better than a Bunny Breakfast! Join us Saturday morning, March 23rd at 10 a.m.
And the whole Bunny family will be there to take pictures with you.
We're going to have breakfast for everyone, including bunny pancakes and waffles.
Yum!
Plus face painting, activities, and door prizes.
Adults and children.
Bring the whole family.
And your friends.
Your coworkers.
And your neighbors.
It's free for everyone.
Register at whc.live. We'll see you there.
The Bunny Breakfast. Yes. And we're making it, again, easy to invite people after service today. We have cute little bunny lollipops for you guys to take and drop off everywhere. Look how cute those are. Bunny lollipops. Grab those after service next Saturday. Again, we want to emphasize the Bunny Breakfast is free. You tell someone they can have a free breakfast in this economy, boom, they're going to be here. So tell everyone you know about it next Saturday. I said it, sir. Oh, you come. What happened?
Well, Miss Ashton just told me to make Bunny Breakfast even more spectacular.
Yes.
Egg-tacular.
Egg-tacular, that's perfect.
We added a whole petting zoo and pony rides. Yeah, I'm going to be there. It's going to be incredible. Don't miss it.
Petting zoo and pony rides. This is the exclusive added to the Bunny Breakfast. Now how many people are going to go to the Bunny Breakfast? Amen. Next Saturday, don't miss it. Hey, you can find out all the information about everything we do. I know it's a lot, but we want to make sure you know about it. All of it is at whc.life. All right, everyone up on your feet. We're going to put 2 minutes on the clock. Find someone around you that you haven't seen or met before and use this icebreaker question. What is your favorite Easter candy? Go!
And I want to give a special welcome to all of you who are joining us online. We are so thankful that you chose to worship with us this Sunday. Before we get over to Pastor and his amazing message he has planned, I want to say a special welcome. Listen, we got Janet watching. We have Lisa watching. We have Anna watching. So many of you are tuning in online, and we really appreciate that. And there is still plenty of time to like, comment, and share. Our pastor is an audience participation preacher, and he loves hearing from you. And so make sure that you're commenting. Comment your prayer requests. Comment your testimonies, the things that you're believing God for, the things that God has already done. We know there are so many of you out there that have so many things you want to share with us, and we want to hear each and every one. Before we go back into service, I just want to do a quick prayer with all of you at home and just pray, Father God, whatever people are dealing with, who are watching, whether that be some sort of diagnosis, as Pastor Chris said, we know that your name is above every name, and we just pray, Lord, that you would heal them. Father, your word says that by your stripes we are healed. Father, people are believing for financial breakthrough. Lord, we just pray right now, Lord, that we know that you are the one who provides. You are the great provider. And no matter what our finances look like, Lord, we know that you are able to provide for us. Whatever types of burdens that we have, we just cast our cares on you, Lord. And we just pray that you would be with us in everything we do this week. Be with us in everything we do today as we go about our day, about our jobs. Lord, you know and you care about that which concerns us. And we thank you, Lord. We just worship you, Father. No matter what is happening happening in our lives, Lord. We take this time to worship you, to commit our lives to you, to commit our hearts to you, Father. So we just thank you, Lord, for everything you're doing in our lives, everything you have done, everything you are doing, and everything you will do. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. And as I said, if you have any other prayer requests, make sure that you comment those. We have pastors standing by who are ready to pray and believe God with you. But as of right now, we're going to go back into service and hear from our pastor.
Everybody, see, friendliest church in town right here at the Harb. Back to your seat, so please remain standing. Thank you so much. Back to your seat. But please remain standing. Did anybody surprise you with their favorite Easter candy? Shout some out. Did anybody say Peeps? Yeah? How about those Reese's peanut butter eggs, right? Yes, God! All right, come on. Help us welcome to this sacred desk, Pastor Dr. Rod Parsley.
Thank you, Pastor Chris. Can we thank God for his holy presence in this place? You know, the number one reason folks don't see their prayers answered is that one word, presence. I'm going to say it again. The major reason folks don't see their prayers answered is presence. Because we do most of our talking at God rather than talking to him and communing with him. So presence is always important on anything you do. Amen?
Amen.
You may be seated. Got a little congratulating to do. First of all, we had 69 Dream Teamers that yesterday, gave out how many invitations? How many? You got it? How many invitations? 10,000. If you weren't part of that 59-60 people, you should really be clapping, encouraging those that did that. The incredible thing is, be seated, please. The incredible thing is my ability to, you know, cast vision and then watch humble gospel helpers bring it all to pass. I began sharing with you, I believe, November of 2023, that it is an astonishing thing that 70% of the people who are born in and will die in the United States of America, think about this. I tell preachers this, and they just fall off their seat. 70% of the people born and dying in this country will never in their lifetime, one time, be invited to any church. And then we wonder, what in the world's going on in America? Well, it's very simple. We divorced ourselves from God, and then we divorced ourselves from his church. And Christians became isolated and introverted, and forgot the major word of the New Testament, a little two-letter word, go. Go. 10,750 people yesterday were personally invited to church. I don't know a church that does that in a year. And we do it every week. Every single week, we're not going to go to heaven. And God said, why didn't you invite anybody? We're not going to do that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Well, I was not able to be on that outreach. I was in prayer at Ohio University. I was deeply in prayer and at times intercession. Because once again, now do you understand, before I say this, over 80% of the high schools in the state of Ohio will never one time win a district championship. district, much less regional, much less go to the state Final Four tournament or win it. Less than 20% of all schools ever in their entire history. Well, HPS was back at the convo. That's a dunk. Was back at the convo at in Athens at Ohio University yesterday. And that's Coach David Dennis. We played the regional championship yesterday on the floor at Ohio University. And that gentleman holding that trophy, the head coach at Harvest Preparatory School, has played 11 times on that floor, only in regional championships. He's won all 11. Yeah. These young ladies here, now this one, I had to tell her to be, I was praying for her because I kept being afraid she's going to step on her hair. That's her hair down there. It's down to her knees. But anyway, those young ladies just won the Ohio State Cheerleading Championship. There it is. And the boys won the regional championship. Our basketball girls won the district championship the last 2 years running. I don't know how many regional championships. These are back to back though, last year and this year. Last year the boys lost in the state championship game because our 20-point scorer was unable to play that game. But they made it all the way back to the Final Four of the state, which will be played Friday at 5:30 in the Dayton University Convocation Center there. They always played that at Ohio State, but I don't know, they must have lost the contract or something. They're paying all these football players so much money, they got any money left for anything. That's all gonna change. That's gonna change. And the kids, the athletes should gain some of the revenues that they bring into these universities. But the way it's structured right now, it's not fair. So they're gonna change it. I have confidence they will. Can we congratulate these wonderful Harvest Prep teams, please? Amen. Okay, John 17:17. Father, sanctify them through your truth. Your word is truth. Now, the only way I can change your future is to change whose words you believe. There's power resident in a seed. Luke chapter 4, the Lord Jesus said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me." In other words, I am the anointed of the Lord, and I carry his anointing. Amen? Yoke-destroying, burden-removing. The very next thing he says, he has not only anointed me, he has anointed me, Jesus of Nazareth, to preach. How many of you believe Jesus was anointed to preach? That he was the master preacher and the master teacher. He said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, so I will preach." And then he gives it great specificity. He says, he anointed me to preach. Very first thing he says he was anointed to do, to preach the gospel to the poor. Don't throw your, that's why we don't use songbooks in here. They used to throw songbooks at me, so I took them out. I said, the first thing he said about his anointing was that he was anointed to preach the gospel to the poor. Now, if you don't like that, you'll have to take that up with Jesus, because he found the place where it was written in the book of Isaiah and said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me," the year of Jubilee. the 50th year. They looked at their calendar and said, it's not Jubilee yet on the Jewish calendar. So they took him out to the brow of the hill. They were going to throw him off. But your Bible said he passed through. He had a passing through anointing. He passed through the midst of them. You can get that anointing too. You can pass through financial trouble and turmoil, period. Now, don't be looking at me like money is evil, because you just spent 40 hours this week chasing it. If it's evil, quit your job, because your reward for the work is not only your personal sense of accomplishment, it is also that you get money in your hand. And that money is simply a means by which you are able to gain what you need or desire in this earth realm. Now, God's name is I Am. And the fourth commandment says that we should not take the name of the Lord in vain. Now, you were all shouting about Jehovah Isus Hekaboth. You were all shouting about Jehovah Eli. You were all shouting about Jehovah Adon Kol Aretz. But when you get to Jehovah Jireh, you've been watching too much internet and social media, and so you contract. You become quiet. And the fourth commandment is, don't take the name of the Lord, I Am, in vain. So why don't you right now say, I am saved,
healed,
delivered,
set free,
in victory. I am provided for. I am not poor. I am rich. I am not misinformed. I am bright. I am not poor. I am rich. Now, some of you feel like you're lying. I can tell. Preacher can always tell, you know. You don't realize it. You send back reverberations. And you're fine till you get to that rich part, because you didn't listen last week while I showed you all the different ways which wealth is measured. Five different ones. Not going to go through them again. Five different ways wealth is measured. Only one is finances and possessions. I'm going to talk to that today when I get back up here. Psalm 81:10, open your mouth with a mighty decree, and I, God, will fulfill it. Now you'll see the words that you speak, so shall it be. That's the scripture of the decade. So why don't you declare and decree? Last week I told you who has your money. The wealth of the sinner is laid up for the just. Ain't got no agreement, because you still don't believe it. God said he gives the task of gathering and storing up wealth to the wicked so that he may hand it over to the righteous. Wow, I got four amens on that. I'm smoking this morning. So we must declare the decree. I told you who had your money. I told you where your money is supposed to be. Somebody tell me where it's supposed to be. In your house. So why don't you right now let God know your name and your address? I want you to shout it at the top of your lungs on three. One, two, three. Shout it again. Shout it again. Just want you to make sure God knows where the transfer is to be sent to. Now say, I have a topos, an open door in 2024. And no man can close that door. Now say, financial stability, come to me, come to my house in the name of I am. Because I am blessed. I receive it for right now to pay all my bills. I receive it tomorrow for the rest of my life. I receive it, say it. I receive it for my children. I receive it for my grandchildren because I am a righteous man and I lay up an inheritance for my children and my children's children. Now somebody shout, because you're not gonna have it. It's an established fact. Amen. You may be seated. Those of you online, those of you on all the social media platforms, those of you watching by television, those of you listening by radio, in Jesus' name, you are part of the family here at World Harvest Church because you are receiving from the anointing on this ministry. And that's the folks that you should sow into, those folks that you are receiving from. Your tithe belongs in your local church. So send those offerings in Jesus' name. Amen. Everybody ready to give, shout, I am blessed. And who's going to bless us? Looks like Pastor Chris.
Yes, sir.
And these lovely folks in the front line. Boy, do we miss our Valor Christian student, college Christian students, or what? I mean to tell you, I miss them so much. Classes begin again, I believe, Tuesday, so they'll be back Sunday, and I'll be glad to see them. Amen. What you got for us there, young man?
Yes, sir. This is an original song that Cameron Fontana and I did together on our last project called Never Let Go.
Oh, never let go. Shout, I'll never let go.
I'll never let go. God bless you as you give unto the Lord today, tithes and offerings, everyone online, every campus. God bless you. Father, we thank you that your word says you will never leave us. You will never forsake us. But you are with us always, God. And we thank you, Father, for your faithfulness in our lives.
As far as the eye can see, horizons prove your majesty, and all of creation bows in awe. A world that was deceived, so the sun was set on humanity, and when it seemed all hope was gone, like a wave you wash away with overwhelming swells of grace, an ocean surrounding us with your great love.
Come on, this is all of our story right here. My stains could not be clean. Say,
my stains could not be clean.
A prisoner of humanity.
Trapped in the chains
of creation's fall.
My world needed redeem.
You loved us so much. So the sun was set upon the tree. Come on, tell them the good news. And hope came crashing in with love.
Like a wave, you wash away with overwhelming swells of grace.
grateful for the love of Jesus today. Oh, God. Father, we thank you so much that through it all, mountain high, valley low, good times, bad times, you will never let us go. We thank you, Jesus.
You will never let go. You will never let go. You will never let go. You never let go. You never let go. Say sound. You will never let go. You will never let go.
Sing it out.
Will never let go. You never let go.
Beautiful church, lift it up again.
You will never let go.
Never let go.
You will never let go.
I walk with you and I know.
You never let go. Never let go. Never let go.
Oh,
you will, you never let go.
We're going to hit the ground running. Are you ready? No, like, are you really, 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 really ready? Because I got some stuff for you today, and we got to move quickly. So get your Bible out. Get your notepad out. Get your iPad out. Get your pad out. Here a pad, there a pad, everywhere a pad. Get it out and get ready, because we got some distance to cover. And I'm gonna ask you to lock in, okay? If you go to Matthew chapter number 6, the 6th chapter of Matthew, right before chapter 7, 6th chapter of Matthew, you'll notice something, especially if you have one of my Jubilee Bibles. We marked it out this way in the Jubilee Bible. And since it's my Jubilee year, you don't seem very happy that I'm that old. This is my 50th year preaching this gospel full time. So if you look in chapter 6, above chapter 6, verse 1, the heading is teaching about charitable giving. The words are in red. So Jesus begins a discourse talking to us about finances. The very next subject that he covers is the Lord's Prayer or the Our Father. So he goes from charitable giving to the master prayer of the entire New Testament, which is based line on line, concept on concept, to the greatest prayer of the Old Covenant, the 23rd Psalm. You with me? So he talks about finances and then goes to the greatest prayer recorded in the New Testament. Now, I broke it up like this just to give it emphasis, because at times we put too much emphasis on the wrong syllable. So he goes then from the Lord's Prayer, keep going. He's still in the same discourse. This is not a new sermon. This is the same one continued. And he goes into, watch, teaching about fasting. So we've gone, think about resurrection seat. We've gone from Jesus prophetically speaking about your finances to Jesus teaching you how to pray, and now he's teaching you about fasting. This is the time of the year when we focus on Easter or Passover. And in order to do that, we focus on three things. We focus on prayer, we focus on fasting, and we focus on seed sowing. So Jesus is following that pattern and telling us how to do all of it in one sermon. I told you he was a master preacher. So then he goes into, are you ready? Treasure in heaven. Treasure. Get it? Say treasure. Treasure. Where? Heaven. On earth. Heaven. At work. Heaven. At your house. Heaven. Treasure in heaven. Watch me. Then he goes into the power of the Holy Ghost, the light of the body. Next, he returns to God and money. So at both ends of his sermon, he's addressing money. Did anybody get that? I just want you to make up, 20th century preachers did not make this up, because that's what the internet tells you all the time by those who have no faith. Go to verse 19. Well, first of all, fasting. I ought to just touch on that and remind you that Jesus said, y'all stop talking to each other about your fast. And remember, a diet is not a fast. You can fast television. You can fast screen time. You can fast your time. You can fast activities. You can fast pleasure. Food works best because most folk, and I'll talk about it a little bit later, most folk have a belly god. The second greatest idolatry in America is food. The greatest idolatry in America is money. So let me ask you a question. Is food evil? What's the second greatest idolatry? Because it's not the food that's evil, it's what you do with it. Good God, that makes sense. Then it says this, do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth. What do most Americans spend their time on? What's the American dream? Own your own home. Fill it up with your own stuff. Drive your own car. Have your own jewels. How much talk is there about what we're laying up in heaven? Some people totally gloss over and forget there are rewards in heaven. Oh, the old songwriter said, I don't want a mansion in heaven, I'll just take a log cabin on the hills of glory. Well, some of y'all, unless you change your ways, gonna end up in a log cabin. Now, your driveway may be made out of gold, but you're gonna be in a log cabin. And you're not gonna have any crowns either. Because some of you ain't ever won a soul. 91% of all professing born-again believers will never win one soul to Jesus in their lifetime. You sure not going to have the soul winner's crown. Amen. Just say out. So here we go. Matthew 6:24. You cannot. Now if you're from Eastern Kentucky, you say can't. Say, I can't worship two gods. Now notice he did not say two things. He said two gods. You with me? At the same time, you will hate one and love the other. Or you will be devoted to one and despise the other. Does anybody notice any gray area? Can't worship two gods, pretty emphatic. Love one, hate the other. Be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot worship the true God while you are enslaved to money. Now, I'm going to help you. There are more people at poverty level in America enslaved to money than there are wealthy people in America enslaved to money. This is where we get the whole thing messed up. Because we want to act like money is unholy. Money is ungodly. People that have money are ungodly. They must have stolen it. Right? And yet, you spend your whole life scratching and clawing to get some. We quote these little shibboleths of tradition, and we have no earthly idea what we're even saying. Boy, we're going to get into it. Turn your frown upside down now. Straighten your halo on your horns. Here we go. This verse is in all probability a Jewish proverb. No man can serve two masters. Say that. No man. Does that include you? No human person can serve two masters. None of us can serve two masters. Watch, much less two gods. Because God is a master. We are not slaves in the modern term of the word. We are, however, bond slaves. Or we are not true believers. We pledge allegiance to God. He is sovereign. He is holy. He is other. He is above all, through all, and in you all. He is the only one God. He is absolutely powerful because he is absolutely holy. Holiness is purity. And he will either be God of all or not God at all. He said, these words are in red, you cannot serve God and money. To which do we give 40 hours a week? You never complain about a movie ticket, an athletic event ticket. Never complain. But let the offering containers come through the aisles. Here's why you can't serve God and money. You ready? Because if you've got two gods, they are polar opposites. Here's why you will hate one and love the other. Because at some point down the line, if you're trying to keep them both sovereign in your life, one will command you to do a thing that will be against what the other is commanding you to do. You cannot serve two gods because they will at some point contradict each other. So being worldly, let me try to get this in a vernacular you can understand. Being worldly or being carnal or being fleshly or being earthly minded is hypocrisy. Again, we use terminology nobody knows what it means. What is a hypocrite? Well, we used to keep them up here on this platform, but we don't keep them up here anymore. But we used to have plants up here. And when I was preaching on hypocrisy, I would go over here and pull a leaf off one and say, this is a hypocrite plant. It looks like a plant. They even sprayed women's cologne on them. Mother Parsley used to spray rose perfume on them. And when people get up here, they'd say, oh, I always smell the anointing when I'm around Mother Parsley. And I just grinned. A hypocrite. What's a hypocrite? A hypocrite is something that takes the place of the real. So it's a substitute. Ah! It's a substitute. There are a whole lot of people that use credit and call it prosperity. They call my house, which they should say, my hypocrite house, because it's not mine, belongs to the bank. This is my car, not your car. That's hypocritical. That car belongs to whatever loan company you got into covenant with, because that's what a contract is, a covenant. Do you know your banker? Do you know who's got your car? No. Do you know their lifestyle? Do you know who they worship? Because you just got in covenant with them. You're really quiet. I'm helping you so much. In this and this alone, we reach a strategic inflection point. We come to a place where we cannot continue as we have been going because we have run into the roadblock of the truth of God's word, where a decision must be made. Choose you this day whom you will serve. If God be God, then serve him. But if Baal be God, serve him. If Mammon is God, then keep serving it. But if God is God, your money should have no hold on you. Somebody say, how much money you got in the bank? Say, which one? The earthly one or the heavenly one? Quiet. It's quiet. I didn't think you cared about money. Oh. So what is mammon? I heard that all my life. Mammon. We do not use the word mammon in 2024. Mammon is a whole lot more than money. It is money, and is translated at times in new translations as money. But it does not begin to cover the scope of mammon. Mammon is that which I serve. It just keeps getting quieter. I'm going to hear crickets in a minute. Whatever you and I count as gain to ourselves. Shall I slow down? Philippians 3:7. But what things are gain to me, those I count as loss for Christ. I got a new shiny truck. Gain. I got a new home. Gain. I got a new suit of clothing. Gain. Those things that we count or consider as gain to ourselves are the things that God will not allow to be our God. He will not allow your pursuit, single people, of a marriage partner as what consumes your thought life. What is your passion? What drives you? Do you get up one time a week on Sunday morning so excited you can barely get your clothes on, which you laid out on Saturday because you were so excited about getting ready for Sunday? Oh no, that's what you do Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, to go to work. Yeah, but I have to work to survive. Work without him. We stand in here and lift our hands. You are the breath I breathe. So what if he doesn't breathe out? And you don't breathe in? How are you going to make it to work? You know when they choose to close Gender Road? Sunday. You know when they choose to change the clocks? Saturday night. Why? They serve the God of this world. God says, I give you 7 days. Now look, I know I'm God and all that, but I created the heaven and earth and all that in them is in 6 days. And I rested on the seventh. Rest is only available to a completed work. You're trying to rest, you haven't completed your work. There's no rest to you. You're on the wheel. God doesn't want you on the wheel. When you're on the wheel, it seems like a burden to read both the 40-day fast devotional and the Crown Him King devotional, both of which can be read in under 60 seconds. But you can't get to it. But pull up your screen time on your cell phone this week. As Brother Sumrall taught me when I was in my early 20s, you don't need more time, son. You got 24 hours in a day, same as everybody else. You need to get yourself organized and quit allowing your flesh to dominate your schedule. I wish I had 5 hours right now. Are you with me so far? Those I count but loss. When are we going to get there? When are truly born again, Holy Ghost filled believers going to get to the point where God puts his hand on a car and says, why are you driving so-and-so's car? Well, you can't give them that car because you'd have to give them the debt of it. I've given 18 cars away. I couldn't give 18 away if I didn't own 18. I stopped paying interest on car notes, which is the world's worst investment you can ever make, except a credit card. Credit card debt right now in the United States of America is at an all-time high. People borrowing money to support a lifestyle they can't finance. And don't look at me funny. I paid my house off when I made $300 a week. I bought my wife a new car and handed it to her the day we got engaged. People say, the Blessed Bible College students, how are we gonna get married? And you're going to work at Chipotle the rest of your life? What are you? I know what you make. What are you doing? See, because we're in lust. We're not in love. How do I know? Because love's patient. Joni and I waited 7 years. I don't recommend that. I also don't recommend 7 minutes. Right? Are you bored? You're acting bored. Say, I am not poor. And if I am, I'm not going to be. Watch this. Some folks serve, as I said, the mammon of belly. You don't believe that? How about Philippians 3:19? Whose end is their destruction? Wow. Whose end is their destruction, whose God is their belly. How much has yours been screaming while you've been denying it a little bit? A little bit. Some aren't even doing that. Can't even find the spiritual strength within themselves to say, no, sir, not for the next 40 days. I'm not touching it. And then you complain about it the whole time. And you tell people. You don't have to say when somebody offers you a potato chip, you don't have to say, no, you Pharisee, no. I am fasting potato chip. Just say no, thank you. God said, don't be like the Pharisees. Run around telling everybody what you're doing. That's your problem. You tell everybody your business. And a lot of business you think you know that you don't know nothing about. Whose glory, the best they've got is their own shame. Wow. Who mind, here it is again, earthly things. Some serve mammon of earthly wealth. Earthly wealth can be mammon, or it can finance the gospel. Let's feed the world, Pastor. Great. It's going to take money to feed the world. Let them starve, Pastor. James 4:13, go to now, you rich men. Today or tomorrow, we will go into such a city and we will continue there a year and we will buy and we will sell and we will get gain. This is why God doesn't bless, because you just want gain. Now, there's nothing wrong. God said, eat the fat, drink the sweet. As long as you're sending for those who have nothing, like nothing, the gospel, never being invited to church, never being witnessed to by your faith. Come on now. Here's a good one. I've never seen a generation like this one. I have never in my life seen a generation so head over heels in love with sleep. Don't believe me? We're still not recovered from last Sunday, where a full 50% of people couldn't make it to church when they were told the day before, months before, if they just look it up, that they were going to lose, brace yourself, an hour of sleep. I only got four people laughing, and they were all here last Sunday. Sleep. Get out of bed. Here's another mammon, cell phones. Here's another mammon, athletic events. Here's another mammon, shopping. Proverbs 6:9, how long will you sleep, you lazy bug, you? Well, what do you think a sluggard is? Get up. Ah! But first, you got to go to bed. You can't. All night long talking to your boyfriend. And get up in the morning. Get up! If you can be 15 minutes late, you can be 30 minutes early. Get up. Get up. Say, get up. Get up. I'm not going to be a sluggard. I'm not going to be lazy. This generation is eaten up and baptized in a heaping double dose of lazy. And it quadrupled at the end of COVID, where everybody's been sitting home in their jammies and want to stay home in their jammies and work while they eat peanut butter and jelly and while they watch their TV and while they're shopping online. And every American company that let people work at home lost 40% or more productivity during COVID, and it's still continuing. Have you noticed businesses are empty? Have you noticed? I went to the doctor the other day. I said, the last time I was in here, which was 6 months ago, you had four people working out here. And the one that was working there told me she was a temp. They were down to one temp. I said, doctor, what in the world is going on? I talked to the nurse. The nurse said, I am now covering three different offices when we used to have three in my position in all three locations. I said, what's going on? Can't find anybody to work. If you are out of work right now, I need to help you, because I can find you 50 jobs tomorrow. Come on, man, get out of bed. Shout, get out of bed. Come on, get out of bed. You want to have more than you've got? Get out of bed. You want to serve God with greater strength? Get out of bed. You want to have a bright mind? Get out of bed. Your mind's asleep. Stop looking at screens for 2 hours before you lay down and you'll sleep. I don't know. I just toss and turn all night long. Well, of course you do. Oh, man. You want me to keep going? I got more of this. I'm through the first half page of 5 pages. I don't know if you can take it. Okay, how about this? Others seek mammon by seeking followers. It's not important who's following you. It's important who you're following. Some, the mammon of influence. This new term. I am an influencer. Till they decide to cancel you. Then who will you influence? So in order to keep your influence, you have to bow your knee to the mammon of influence. Because at some point, those that you're influencing are not going to hear about your God. Start posting that. And see how much influence you have left. You with me? Social status. The applause of men, preachers. Got a preacher in here. I had one of the, what would be perceived as the most successful ministry gifts in America in 3 generations. Look me in the eye. And I said, you've changed your message. I don't, whatever your delivery is, I don't often run the back of the seats anymore. I'm 67. And my body does not want to follow my spiritual lead. Had a preacher look me in the eye, and I said, you've changed your message. Not many folks bold enough or brave enough to say that, but that's what I said. They said, you're right. And I said, well, what's going on? You know what they said to me? I am intoxicated by the applause of the people. Mammon. Mammon. The approval of men to the discredit of the approval of the only one that matters. You with me? Are you following along? Herein lies the trinity of mammon. God woke me up last night. You know, I go to bed, go to sleep, pray. And I was praying, Abba, I belong to you. Lord Jesus, I worship you. Holy Spirit, I welcome you. And I went to sleep with that. And then God woke me up. And he said, there's a trinity of mammon too. Wow. So I said, please tell me. Here it is. The trinity of mammon. The sensual. What pleases your senses, including sexuality, the sensual, mammon. Second, the secular. What that world through advertising keeps telling you is what you must have. Secularism, the secularization of the church, secular humanism in education. The church has become a secularist society. Well, let's all vote, which we have to do because we have no apostolic authority, nor do we understand biblical authority. The church is a bunch of Miriams. Why do we have to listen to Moses? God talks to me too. Okay. You're a secularist. Secular, worldly, according to this world. Right? Okay. Please remember, this world system is built on one thing, debt. Everything in this nation resides, rests in, and is supported by debt. Do you know how much America owes? Over 70% of people living in America today do not have enough to pay themselves out of debt if their life depended on it. Now, it's not because they haven't received money, because the poorest among us working have had over $1 million in their working life pass through their hands. But that's the point. It passed through their hands because they had to have, had to have, had to have, had to have. The sensual, the secular, and here's the biggest one of all, self. Do we serve ourselves or do we serve Him? It's quiet. We cannot be obedient to God and mammon. These two are polar opposites. Hear the prophet, if Baal be God, serve him idols. If idols be God, serve them. But if God be God, serve him. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. That means we'll miss work before we'll miss church. That means we'll stay home from the movie before we'll spend our tithe to go there. You say this isn't scriptural. I have to disagree with you. 50% of the teachings of the Lord Jesus in the Gospels involve your money. 50%. Two-thirds of all the parables of Jesus, he talks about money. There are 500 verses in the New Testament on prayer. There are 2,000 verses dealing with your money. The only thing, in fact, Jesus preached more about finances, kingdom finances, than he did on the subject of immorality. These are the weightier matters. The only subject Jesus spoke more about is love. That's it. So what is the 1% mentality, right? According to recent studies, to attain a spot in the wealthiest 1% of income earners in America, you would need to have a yearly income of $597,815. Father, I thank you that a significant portion of the people that trust you, that are faithful in their tithing and their giving, that worship you above anything else, that put you ahead of anything else in their lives, will attain that status in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And those of you that are not clapping are being hypocritical. Because if I wrote you out a check for that right now, not a one of you would not take it and cash it. Well, you can get there, you know. See, you got to break through your own mentality. And the only way to break through your own mentality is break through the words you say and the things you believe. Watch this. You would have to have a net worth of $11,100,000. A net worth. Now, that includes all your possessions, your home, your savings, your 401, crick, your all that stuff. You'd have to have 11.1 million estate. Father, now don't act like I'm just praying this now. I pray this every day. That you, many of you, will attain an estate valued at least $11,100,000. If you were in that category, your tithe would be $60,000 a year. Why wouldn't you want to tithe more than you make right now? Well, you never will. Unless you change your mind, which changes your heart. Turn the television off. I saw a young man the other day. He started a business his freshman year in high school. Of course, he was willing to work. He had to get up at 4:30 in the morning in high school and go take care of his business, then go to school, then do his homework, and before he went to bed, check on his business. He was making $2,000 a week. That's $104,000 a year as a freshman in high school. You know what he was doing? Filling up vending machines. How many am I talking to right now, no raise of hands, please, that are making a, oh, that was clear profit. That wasn't how much he took in. That's how much he made. He took in closer than $250,000 a year. Filling up vending machines as a freshman in high school. And all you know to do is complain to your boss. Well, I guess I'm your Lord. Better treat me like it. I'm not your mammon. God's your source. I told a group the other day, I'm weary with having to be around and work with a bunch of people that absolutely have no earthly idea what living by faith is. Living by faith begins with sowing. And if you sow begrudgingly, just understand, you have no harvest. If you sow without faith, you have no harvest. But if you'll sow because it really doesn't mean anything close to you what he does, and you're serving him and not sensuality, right? Self and secularism, then letting go is easy. Letting go is easy. But I've been living this way. What's 8 from 67? 59. I've been living this way for 59 years. I didn't start yesterday. But God has always had my heart, because God has always had my money. Miss Joni says, when I'm gone and she retires, she's going to pitch a tent in the middle of the Harvest Prep football field. You say, why would we do that? Because we took our inheritance and we built that. That's why. Now, I didn't say that so you think I'm some, that was, I don't know, 14 years ago or something. It just came up to me. You say, well, yeah, you're a big-time preacher. I know a bunch of big-time preachers that die with nothing. No family, no wife, after they've been through three. I've been in this pulpit for 47 years. I've been married to my wife, the only person I've ever been married to, and the only person I was intimate with. My entire ministry, my entire adult life. Because I'm not bound to sensuality. I'm not bound to secularism. Do you have any idea how many people have asked me through the years to go be a Tony Robbins type? Do you have any idea the money that I've been offered to enter politics? Preachers come to me and say, why do you stay in Columbus, Ohio? Why aren't you in Atlanta? Why aren't you in Dallas? Why aren't you in Fort Lauderdale or Miami? Why aren't you in Los Angeles? One reason, I never received that directive. And if I did, I would. You understand? All I'm trying to tell you is stop living for this world and God will bless you. I mean, he'll go like out of his way to bless you. He'll take people that were bankrupt and make them finance the gospel with millions of dollars. I mean, we got to have some one percenters around here, y'all. In the kingdom, I mean. How much money have you gotten for other organizations in the last couple years? Any idea?
$700
million. Now, don't ask him for a loan because he's not going to give you one. If you can't give somebody something, don't loan it to them. Secularists, loan you money. Don't insult my spiritual intelligence. One of the greatest, wealthiest preachers anyone has ever known in three generations had less than an eighth grade education. It's all in who you're serving. Sell out to him. Just sell out, man. Sell out. He says, give $10, give it. If you wanted to go get ice cream and it's going to cost $10, you wouldn't say, I don't know. Come on. Come on. Stop buying girls' engagement rings that look like they came out of a Cracker Jack box. And if he puts that on your finger, tell him, come back when he's ready. I'm not playing. You think he's going to have money after you marry him? Come on. And I'm not talking about having money. I'm talking about being where we need to be with Jesus Christ actually on the throne of everything in our lives. Because when he died for us, he died for all of us. He died for everything in our lives. Everything. The hair on our head, the shoes on our feet, what we're going to do with our time. Your time is not your time. Your time is his time. I feel God, somebody shout. Everybody standing, Lift your hands and say, Jesus, I make you Lord. I receive your lordship. I acknowledge your sovereignty in my life. I want you to control areas of my life. And yet, I've not surrendered all the areas of my life. And today, with all my heart, I want to call you Lord. Lord of all, speak to me, and I will follow. Where you lead me, I will follow. I will do what you bid me do. And I'm humbled. I am humbled that you would ever use me. Thank you, Jesus. Let me bring glory to your name in my life. Amen. 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 Blessed be the holy name of God forever. If you want to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, there'll be people to pray with you at this altar. Those of you online, just drop the number one in the comments. We will get directly back with you. We will get literature in your hands and pray for you. There's no reason to go to hell when heaven's available. And Jesus loves you. What a joy to surrender to his leadership, his lordship, and his sovereignty. I trust you've grown today. Amen. Lord, take sickness and disease from the midst of your people. Bless them now, spirit, soul, and body, and in everything that pertains to life and godliness. Amen. 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 I love you. We'll see you Wednesday night.
What an incredible message we heard from our pastor as he preached more from his book, Idolatry in America. Be sure that you are reading over those scriptures. He talked about we can't serve God and mammon, and what mammon looks like in our lives, what mammon looks like in your life. Be sure that you're reading over these scriptures. You can even go back on WHC.life and listen to this service again and get it into your spirit and share it with those that you know. If you did give your life to the Lord this morning, we want to say congratulations. If you dropped a one in the comments, there's a link that you can click. We're going to send you an ebook from our pastor called New Direction as you embark on this new life with Christ and make the decision that you will be glad you made when you stand before God in eternity. And if you are on Facebook or on YouTube and you see that one, be sure to encourage people, let them know that they made a great decision. I want to go over really quickly a couple things we have coming up. So we've got Easter. We've got Good Friday service on Sunday. Remember, we're dressing down because it is serve day. We're going to be serving all over this ministry after service. On Saturday, we have an outreach. So you can join us at 9:45 as we go out and invite the community to church. And then we've got our bunny breakfast on Saturday. That is at 10 a.m. Bring everyone. It's free breakfast buffet. You heard pastors say there's going to be a petting zoo. There's going to be a pony ride. It's going to be amazing. And then on Wednesday, don't miss Orthodoxy as our pastor goes through what we believe and why. There's a lot of announcements all the time, but you can go to WHC.life to find everything that we have going on. And if you did not have a chance to give in this service, we're going to give you the opportunity to do that right now. Have a great rest of your Sunday. We'll see you back here on Wednesday night.
Sowing into the kingdom of God has never been easier or more secure than with Smart Giving. Any smartphone will work. To use your Smart Giving, open your text messaging app and send a message to number 45777. In the message of your text, type the amount of your gift, space WHC. If it's your first time giving, you'll receive a secure link to set up your account. Select your home campus, enter your giving method, and where you would like to receive your instant giving receipt. If you already registered, the process is the same. Just send a text message to 45777, type the amount of your gift, space WHC. You'll receive your receipt immediately. If you prefer, you can also sow online at WHC.life or by phone or mail. Just call the number on your screen or send your gift to the address displayed.
Powerful grace, I sing the song of the reed.